principal director of the public information bureau of my government. I would like to compliment him for joining together with the Facebook in organizing in this workshop. Kendra Sarkar mein mera saathi, mera sahyogi, Shri Rajvardhan Rathod ji, Director for India, South and Central Asia, Facebook, Ms. Ankita Das, Global Head of Politics and Government, Mr. John Toss Parker, Media Heads, friends and youngsters who are all participating in this today's workshop. I am extremely happy to be at this gym. At the same time, I feel sorry I have to leave early because I had to catch up with another program and then catch up with one more program and then catch up with one press conference, then catch up with one flight and then reach up and then attend another program in Hyderabad. We are all practically running. In spite of running, we are not able to meet the challenges because the challenges are many. We ourselves have opened up so many fronts, and because the Prime Minister is very keen to transform India. For transformation, you need information. Transformation will be more quick and speedy if there is proper information. And information with confirmation is like an ammunition. Ammunition, and this Instagram program is an information with confirmation, because photo never lie. Of course, now my PA was cautioning me, sir, there is morphing now, be careful. Okay, that apart, but still, the photo, the graphics, they have their own value. Friends, the communication has always been a core function of every leader, every organization. However, the transformed coordinates of the competitive space of ideas has brought into the center like never before in human history. An organization that gives stepmother status to communication is creeping its own obituary. Social media gives an opportunity to do this in a very cost-effective manner. It is thus a very powerful tool in minimum government, maximum governance. I am confident that this endeavor, where government have joined hands with the global organization like Instagram, would help enhance the government's reach and capacity in delivery of information to the people. It is said that a picture is worth 1,000 words. However, in today's age, a good picture is perhaps worthier now than ever before in human history. In an era where great presentation is almost an important as great event, visual communication is an area that presents a lot of challenges as well as opportunities. Instagram for us would like a rainbow to visualize the story of emerging new India. The Prime Minister is talking about new India, where opportunities, ideas, innovations, incubation, stand-up, start-up, lot of new ideas. The Prime Minister wants to unleash the force of growth which are there in the people of India. And for that, he chooses the social media as a great communication, apart from our regular media and all. And he is able to reach to the maximum number of people within the country and outside the country. Just now, our DGP AB has said that we are very happy to know that our Indian Prime Minister, Sri Narendra Modi, has the largest following in Instagram across the globe, surpassing even the United States of America's president also. It's a very happy news for all of us. Because the communication is very key. Communication is the key for the growth, for the development, for the transformation of the country. Friends, the colors of India, through its diversity, celebrated through festivals, cultural practices, region-specific dresses, can best be experienced through visual images. And I am glad that Instagram has offered this platform as a communication tool. With a global user base of over 600 million and a rapidly growing Indian community, Instagram has become a suitable place for government to visually engage with citizens and other Instagram or other stakeholders, and to communicate with the new generation of digital users. It is learned that in 2015, more photographs were captured on camera phones than the entire analog era. This new world indicates that the way people are communicating with each other is changing, and for governments to be successful, they should seek to match that evolution with their own efforts to communicate in the new ways. For government departments world over, transparency is now required and necessary feature of governance. In the new digital age, citizens will not be content with just information. They will have ever higher expectations from us on the context, promptness and way in which the information is communicated, not just of its substance alone. Today we talk of social media everywhere. It has become the most effective medium to communicate thoughts, ideas and beliefs. For those who believe in numbers, here is a quick fact. Prime Minister Narendra Modi, as I told you, is the most followed world leader on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, Google Plus and even Instagram. On Facebook, our PM has over 40 million followers, and on Instagram, he has more than 7 million followers. The social media is no longer an icing on the cake. It is the cake. Not only does news break and spread on social media, the social media wars that are often dismissed as an ideal charter shape the action on TV screens, newspaper pages, dinner tables, boardrooms, streets, and thus the minds and hearts of citizens. The challenge this poses to organizations, individuals, and in particular governments are huge. Well, so are the opportunities. Under the leadership of Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi, the Government of India is already laying a strong focus on social media. The Prime Minister has already communicated that by 2019, mobile phones would be the biggest interface tool and the digital media would contribute to a great extent to reach out to the people. Recalibration and course correction is sometimes needed in one's communications approach. We need to have the capacity to listen what our people are saying and engage with them meaningfully. Our communicators should be able to provide actionable intelligence and inputs from social media to our policy makers in order to aid them in making better decisions. I'm happy to say that our government has been very well aware of and responsive to the role of social media in governance. Underlying the social media focus of the government is the philosophy that rather than expect citizens to knock out at our door, we go and engage with them wherever they are. To the end, with the Government of India working hard to institutionalize the creative and systematic use of social media within the government in order to better up into the promise of this tool in advancing the cause of good governance, I compliment my PIB on Instagram for organizing this workshop, which will be a definitive steps in this direction. Nobody is perfect. Everybody has to learn. The learning is a process throughout the life. Everybody, throughout the life, in every moment, on every issue, on every occasion, there will be something to learn. There is something to learn. So that's why I also feel the ministers also should learn. Nobody is an expert now, after all. You know, we the earlier generation, we need to learn more, particularly the new technology and all. My granddaughter is more smart than me. Not in height and weight or dress, but in ideas, in catching up with the situation and all. They are more energetic and also they want to learn as much as they can. So I also tell my ministerial colleagues also, let us also learn. Everyone should learn, 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 not yearn, 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 even ministers also. That's my belief. So friends, today I am confident that this workshop would help us in this. I also hope that all of us present here are able to arrive at a better appreciation and understanding of the larger phenomena and the role of social media, thereby making our organization socially wiser. There will be some side effects along with the effects because of social media, because there is no regulation or there is no censor, as you people in the media face. There is no editor to edit what you write. But at the same time, we must leave it to the better judgment of the people. And your message, your communication, or your Instagram, or whatever you want to put it on Twitter, finally, its value depends on its content and its correctness. It may create sensation for a while. Afterwards, it will die. It will have a natural death. It will not be repeated. It will not be retweeted also. So keeping that in mind, people who use the social media, I always tell, lot of channels are coming nowadays. Every day, morning, evening, some new channel comes. There is a lot of competition also, and they come to us, sir, as a minister, please give us your blessings or your message. I always tell them, be nearer to truth. Keep away from sensation. This is my advice. Even for the social media users also, my advice is, be nearer to truth, to the reality. Keep away from sensation. That will make a better nation. Because if you use this medium to communicate something which is not real, then you will not be a real hero. If you are able to make a better communication with proper, as I told you, with information and confirmation, that will be for the betterment of the country, and it will be a great ammunition to influence the society. Ammunition means not to, I'm not talking of bombs or other this thing. With the information, if you are able to communicate in a better way, that will be an ammunition to change. The Prime Minister, see his ideas, see his Mann Ki Baat, how much powerful it is, how it is capturing the imagination of the people, even the Beti Bachao, Beti Padao, Swachh Bharat, or Pahal, giving up of the subsidy of the LPG, and yesterday's decision of doing away with this red light, bacon red light, small thing, but message has gone across the country. So that's the best way of communication. Let us all exchange our ideas and come to better conclusions and then pass on the message to others. My compliments to all the organizers for the organizing workshop, and also my best wishes to all the participants. As I told you, I have to rush to the other program, which is little away in Taj, the other Taj. So I have to go to that place. Sorry, I am leaving the meeting in between. My colleagues will be there. All the best. Thank you very much. Namaskar. Jai Hind.